We're bringing you another update to an exclusive that we covered right here on Indisputable. Black male decides to hit record on his cell phone because he has been accused of stealing. According to him, he hit record after the woman utilized the N-word. She then utilizes the N-word again and he says, you know I'm recording you, right? She then proceeds to tell him, well, that's against the law here. He goes home after she threatens to have him arrested, basically. He goes home. He gets a visit from police. The police take his cell phone. According to the black male, they erase all of his information and his Google information as well, Google Cloud or wherever the information was stored. Then he contacts the media. We report on it. What happens after the producers contact the police station? They send cops to his home. They're just knocking on his door. It's caught by the video. We got all the evidence right here. They leave. He then calls the police station. He says, why did you all come to my home? They say, oh, we got a warrant out for your arrest. He turns himself in the next day. We got the video for that as well. They ended up charging him with multiple felonies. And then after he went to the police precinct, after he contacted the media, they then sent him a ticket in the mail claiming that his license is suspended, contrary to the proof he provided to Indisputable. Let me highlight this story. He's a custodian at West Junior High School. This is in Pennsylvania. Galvin Dudley. Mr. Dudley was arrested on December 8th for recording a conversation with another employee at the school he worked at. After he complained, a white colleague called him the N-word. Mr. Dudley was then fired. Dudley says when he told her he had just recorded the colleague saying the N-word, she threatened to have him arrested for wiretapping. Let me take you to the first video of when the cops are leaving his house after taking his cell phone, according to Mr. Dudley. Here it is.
Well, we're gonna have to come in. Who's here with you?
Me and my children.
Just you and your children. How many kids you have?
Three.
Three. Okay. They sleeping?
One. Two of them sleeping. One at four.
Well, we don't want to wake them up. Who is your wife or fiance? I don't know her relationship.
My wife.
Your
she's
wife?
Not here.
Okay. Is she working?
She's working.
Okay. All right. Well, we're gonna have to come in just to make sure nobody else is here other than your kids. But we'll sit down and talk.
According to Mr. Dudley, that was his cell phone. They took his cell phone. Now remember, what did the officer say? We need to come inside to make sure nobody's here but your children. What? So you searched the home? You got to have a warrant for that, okay? They did not. Now, after we called the school and the police station, four officers arrived at his home, knocked on his door, and did not say anything. Let me take you to that video. The video shows they never said police open up or police we have a warrant for your arrest. None of that took place in the video. Mr. Dudley then called the police station, said why were you all at my house today? They said oh well you have a warrant for your arrest, you have to come to the station. He comes to the station, he turns himself in. And then the saga thickens. I'm gonna give you some background to this as a reminder. A student lost their wallet. Okay, this is where it starts. A student lost a wallet. Dudley says school administrators asked him to come to their office for a computer training. He gets to the office, remember he's the janitor. He says he was excited to learn a new skill. He gets there They then accused him of taking the wallet. On December 6th, Mr. Dudley filed a written complaint at the school about Detective Miller. Okay? That's your complaint. The complaint reads apart. On November 23rd, 2022, two detectives came to my house with a search warrant to search my home and vehicles. They took my phone instead of investigating the woman who used racial slurs and harassed me with disrespect and humiliated me. They violated my First Amendment right. Okay? All right? Now, he's doing the right thing. He's making the complaint. He's telling them, listen, I stole nothing. He even told the lady, hey, I'm recording you. Now remember, how was she aware of the recording? Because he said, I'm recording you. He said that. And obviously, she said the N-word, because if she had not, who gives a damn about the recording? And who all has a connection to this woman to where they're willing to do this to one individual? Arrest him, go to his door, create an additional warrant, and now there's something else. Dudley received a ticket in the mail, let's put it up. He then later gets a ticket in the mail from the police department for driving on a suspended license. This was on December 7th, a day after he filed his complaint with the department. Dudley showed Indisputable a valid New York driver's license. Dudley told Indisputable his wife is worried the police will continue to harass his family. Pocono Mountain Regional Police Detective Lucas Bray responded to Dudley's complaint this morning. He told Mr. Dudley his department's investigation, charges, search warrant, and traffic citation were all lawful. No, well, we're going to look into it, Mr. Dudley. We are going to launch an internal investigation. That would clear your officers if they did nothing wrong, Detective. Dudley emailed a complaint 6 days after the initial school meeting on October 13th. Dudley's email tells administrators he alleges he was called the N-word on October 17th. Are they investigating the administrator who allegedly called him the N-word? We have no evidence of that. At a follow-up hearing with the school's attorney on October 24th, Dudley requested to play his recording of the incident. The attorney for the district, Michael Levin, denied his request. He told Dudley in an email, you will be permitted to provide your side of the story at the informal hearing. There's more. Levin also wrote to Dudley, you're not permitted to play for us, and we will not listen to the recording that you allegedly made. It is alleged that the recording you took was made in violation of the law. If that is true, then any use is not permitted. Is anybody concerned about the woman wrongfully terminating the brother and calling him the N-word? This person is around children. Does anybody give a damn about the actual, credible, ethical, and moral violation of this woman? Nope, not so far. Dudley says he was fired without explanation, and he then had to turn himself in to the police on December 8th. I have so much more. Dudley had a Samsung S11 phone. When he went to retrieve his documents and images from Google Drive, he says everything was wiped. Here's a photo of Galvin with his wife and three kids. Dudley's wife said the police could not initially share the charges with her because they were still waiting for the school district to add additional charges against Mr. Dudley. Need I remind everyone, you know, one charge that's not on the docket, one charge he did not receive, theft. He stole no wallet. There's no charge of theft. Let's go to the wife. She said, and I quote, my husband is not a thief because my husband is an honest person. I've known him for more than 13 years. He doesn't take things. After trying to fire him, they're trying to paint a picture of Galvin. We come from the inner city where we have to be a little rough to survive. When he speaks, it could come off as rough and intimidating. We can't change someone else's perception. I think they're trying to paint a picture of him as an angry black man. Can we be very clear? At this point, it would be a problem if he was not an angry black man. Look at what they're doing. This is justifiable anger at this point. Dr. Elizabeth Robinson, let's put the picture up. That is the superintendent of schools. And then you have the police chief, Chris Wagner. The police deny Dudley's allegations. A department press release states, investigators found no evidence of racist statements in Dudley's recordings. What? Okay. A forensic capture of a cellular device not only captures content on the device, but will also indicate any files that have been deleted. No files, videos, or other content has been deleted since the device was secured by police investigators. The device will also be made available to Mr. Dudley's defense team for their own forensic evaluation. Damn, all of this for a cell phone. Now, they revealed themselves, they don't know it. They revealed themselves. What did their comment say? Their own commentary said, hey, we listened to it. You know, the woman who they said the N-word, she didn't say the N-word. That's what's important. Wait a minute, you all did all of this in order to make that kind of public proclamation. So this was not about the statute, this was about exonerating the allegation of one woman who allegedly said the N-word, because that's the emphasis of your own statement about your misconduct alleged by Mr. Dudley. But instead of addressing your alleged misconduct at the police department, you decided to address the content of the recording. That's what you did, revealing that this was about exoneration rather than justice. You wanted to exonerate the alleged racist in the story. Dudley has not yet spoken to the public defender. He says he appeared in court without an attorney on December 8th. The school district, they have not responded to us at all. All right. We're staying on top of this story. I have some other developments happening as well. But you see exactly what's happening here. Now, he is a microcosm of the macrocosm of this dynamic all across the country. Don't think this is only happening to Mr. Dudley. And they will do more if they can get away with it. He now has multiple felony charges. This man has multiple felony charges, but he stole no wallet. He committed no egregious act. He harmed no one. He committed violence to nobody. But this is what happened. All right, consciously, what are your thoughts here, bro?
Man, he got felony charges and they took his job. For me, from an international relations standpoint, a lot of American legal system is championed because how everybody gets to presume innocent or proven guilty, because everybody gets the due process of law, and because the legal system in America is so great and so transparent. Our country has went and invaded other countries, but doing significantly less than what's happened to this gentleman right here. So for me, it is really thinking about the hypocrisy of democracy or the political paradox. And the last thing I'll say is that when you try to assert your humanity or your position in a particular way that piss folks off, they'll try to put you in your position.
Yeah.
How dare you try to, you know what I'm saying, do something to me? How dare you try to record me? Who are you gonna tell on me? Are you gonna tell on me? I'm gonna tell the folks you're trying to tell on me and show you who really got power around here and show you what your position really is.
That's exactly what this is about, brother. You hit the nail on the head. This is about a black male who asserted his rights, who decided to stand up for himself. And there's a power structure that said, we're going to put this Negro in his place. That's what this is. We're going to continue to highlight and expose what's happening in his local community.